You know, the fun part about doing events where you have multiple setups are just trying to figure out the logistics of it all. And I say the fun part sarcastically because it's not a lot of fun sometimes. For instance, tomorrow I'm doing an event where I have a wedding indoors in a barn, and I have a ceremony outdoors near a lagoon. So it's two separate setups. I have a portable battery-powered ceremony system that'll work fine for this. It's small, it goes up in about, I don't know, 10 minutes, 15, counting hauling the stuff back and forth. It's real simple. Probably less time than that. Real efficient. And then there is, of course, the reception system, which is bigger with lights and a bigger PA and all that stuff. It's the main system. If I have a ceremony that starts at 2:30 and a reception that starts at 5, what do you do? Do you go in early in the day, like maybe 2 hours early, set up the reception indoors first, leave it there, and then deal with the ceremony setup after that, do the ceremony, break down the ceremony system, load it up, and then just go into the reception hall? You could, and that's how I think I'd prefer to do it. But this venue is probably over an hour away, and I do have an event tonight, which is Friday. I'm gonna want my rest. And, you know, if I can buy myself an hour, I think I will. So after I rethink it, it's like, okay, if the ceremony starts at 2:30, it can't go any longer than an hour. That puts us at 3:30. I have an hour and a half before my start time indoors. What am I doing for that hour and a half? Well, I could set my system. But a lot of people don't like doing that. A lot of people would prefer to have it all set up first. Somebody suggested, yeah, start your reception setup and then do your ceremony, then finish your reception setup. Some people said, I don't like setting up in front of people. I always want to have everything set before they come into the room. Ideally, I'd like to as well, but just looking at the logistics of this and how long I have to be there, I'm thinking that I'm going to set up the reception after ceremony because there's time. Yeah. It's not a lot of setup. It's a pretty simple setup. I can have it up, probably loaded in and set up for the most part in about a half hour. I'm not real concerned with that. So I'm going to opt to do that. I've told the client I'm doing it. And they're like, perfect. Let's do it that way. I mean, otherwise, I've been in situations where I've set up early indoors for the reception. And then after the ceremony, I've got a couple hours between. And I don't know what to do with myself, so I just play like this 2-hour cocktail set for free. If it was closer, if things were starting a little later in the day, I might opt for that. But since it's starting pretty early, I'm gonna set up in between. That's just my call on this one. But you gotta kind of figure out these logistics every time you do an event. And make sure you're allowing yourself plenty of time. But in my case, I also need to allow myself the energy to perform. And if I'm there several hours before I really need to be, and I'm doing manual labor, I might burn myself out. If I pace myself, I think this might go a little smoother for me. So that's why I've made that call. But no call is wrong. These are just things that you have to figure out every time you do an event like this. Just a quick vlog. I'm doing a disco party tonight. Poolside. I don't start until 5:30. It's like 1 now. I've got plenty of time. I will leave early for this. I'll probably be up there an hour and a half early because I think when I'm leaving, I'm going to beat traffic. If I waited a little longer to leave, I get stuck in traffic. So I almost have to be there early or I get stuck in traffic and I might end up there late. Logistics. They're a lot of fun. That's it. Just a quick video for you. Talk to you soon. Take care of yourselves. I appreciate you so much. Stay tuned for some hot, steamy gig log action from this weekend. Practice and enjoy.